We're about 50 miles off the Moroccan coast. We are averaging 9 knots.
In the last episodes, we crossed from the south of Spain to the Canarian Islands. It was a very relaxed crossing. We had circumstances that looked a little bit like Atlantic crossing in the Passat winds. We had some trouble with the A2 spinnaker, 240 square meters, that went loose in the top of the mast and ended up under the boat. I think it was in the middle of the night because they had to take me out of bed. When the boat still has some speed through the water and that 240 square meter is sort of hanging next to it or under it, that's a bit of a worry. Graciosa is a nice anchorage to stop when you do the crossing. Easy to drop your anchor during the night, so it doesn't matter when you come in. Then on the anchorage you see a small sort of trimaran. It looked like a homemade one. And then you are completely surprised with what kind of material people just cross oceans. Lots of boats from the Gliwo all come in at Graciosa in the same anchorage. And you realize how nice it is to be with a group of people and go around the world. Drink coffee, have a drink, have dinner together. Everybody helps each other, have spare parts for each other, if there are repairs or whatever. Drink coffee, have a drink, have dinner together. We really enjoy it.
2 years ago, Marijke was standing all the way up there.
It doesn't look impressed, this captain.
It's a cool little place, isn't it?
Mark, do you think it's too high, this one? Or is it worth it?
No, no, just go. Go, go. Well, it's just normal.
Okay. Let's see.
Another one.
Yes, another one.
So no wind this morning. It's a good time to go and check the A2, the connection between the sock and the top of the sail itself came loose. Not even sure what was there to connect it. Should be just a little loop. Go and check whether the A2 is still in one piece as it was in the water, dragging next to and behind the boat. Where's Inky Blue? Because Inky Blue will try to entangle their Jennaker. They have exactly the same problem as we had with it. So we gave them our tip to solve it, and hope that it works for them as well. Everything's still really, really wet. Doesn't seem to have any damage. That's good. So only the connection between the sock and the swivel on the top of the sail got loose. Let's discuss how to improve it a bit so that the sail stays up there instead of joining us on water level. It's drying a bit, but we have to be really fast when the wind picks up.
I look through the camera, I don't see it. I just aim at you.
Now we're using the symmetrical spinnaker. There's not a lot of wind, but we're going higher up. The apparent wind increases then. And we should just manage to sail around the corner of Lanzarote. And then we'll head to the south end. Tina is doing one of the things she's really good at. Food! And Marijke is doing something she's really good at as well. Steering the boat. It's hard work, but somebody has to do it.
It is nice when you have so much solar on the boat, but you have to realize that when you're sailing south, like we are doing now, that your sails are constantly blocking all the panels.
So probably our dear friends who do the Utomer angle sailing are going faster than we are, but we're getting close even.
I hope you're well. We were just looking at whether we're going to stay tonight. Before tonight we would take the anchorage outside of Marina Rubicon.
Yes, that was our plan also, sort of northwest of the marina.
again. The icky blue is still in front of us.
Spec Angels are having a preview.
Not even the next episode, but the episode after that.
Without having anything on board, like stuff for sushi or whatever, Tina manages to prepare the tuna in 5 different ways. It was a lovely meal.
Yeah. Surya looks to the north. Greatcircle is looking to the east, and Akaroa is looking to the south on the same anchorage, and there was even wind.
Together with Inky Blue and Speck Ain't, we are going for a trip over the island to the volcano and to the winery. Although it's very touristic, it is nice to see, and it gives you a good impression about the inland of the island.
And these are owned by private companies.
More or less 3-4 staria.
Okay.
Another one have 5-6 staria.
Okay.
And then the wine cellar is only one.
Okay.
But they buy every vineyard for the people. You don't see any wine area in the world without me.
Very special wine area.
We zitten hier weer lekker met spekeentjes te eten. Ja, omdat we een beetje op de Nederlandse tijd zijn.
Ja, hebben we lekker een beetje
last. Morning. It's 5:30 and we're still at the anchorage at Playa Blanca. Today we are going to leave to Tenerife straight. It's just a straight line, the wind will be perfect. But we can't use the mainsail, so we're a little bit in doubt which sail to use. We're probably going to set the dawn with Jenniker. The wind is supposed to be between 10 and 13 knots. And we should be able to run that sail all by itself. The balance will not be optimal, but it should work. And let's see whether it gives us enough speed. We're hoping for 7 knots at least. That will enable us to reach the anchorage at Tenerife around midnight. So. The Jenniker didn't pull out right away, but then we notice if we roll it back in a little bit then and try it again, then sometimes it works fine. It's getting a little bit light already.
Early morning is not my best moment of the day, to say the least, but I helped Mark out of the anchorage and we rolled out the Jenniker, and then I went into bed again for a couple of hours. But Mark always enjoys the sunrise very much.
Testing the Ray Marine as well. Marijke was asleep this morning, so we changed the autopilot to port side. Today we're going in a straight line to Canary. Same heading all day, and so it doesn't really matter that this autopilot only has a heading mode. So we changed the Dawn with Jenniker for the A2 again. To be honest, I don't think we're going to use the Jenniker a lot anymore. If we would do it again, we wouldn't take the Jenniker. We would take the A2 and we would probably just buy a Code Zero like the one we had on the lagoon. Jenniker was giving us 6, 7, sometimes 8 knots depending on the angle. And with the A2 it's immediately 2 knots more, so we're between 8 and 9 now. And, that'll help getting us there before midnight instead of 4 a.m. Kind of a big difference for the harmony, the peace and harmony on board. It really is. This is more like it. Still about 100 miles to go, and it's not a lot of work to set it. This is the construction we made yesterday together with Rob from Enter Joy. Well, the Dyneema wasn't pre-stretched, so it came out this morning a couple of centimeters. We brought it back and now it's just a couple of millimeters out, so it should be okay like this. The repair, of course, is a very simple repair. So as long as we make sure that the boom stays where it is, then that's not really a problem. And then we'll head for the marina the day after. Today is the 2nd of November, so we still have almost 3 weeks. So normally it shouldn't be a problem, but then again, there are other boats with issues as well, of course. It's always competing on the same resources. You can see huge difference between the Dawn with Jenniker and the A2. So we're doing 10 knots, but A2 only. The Gran Canaria is over there. Well, we're about halfway, crossing from Lanzarote to Tenerife.
Oh, the sun is setting behind Tenerife. Still 37 miles to go. And the wind is dying, so this will take us another 5 to 6 hours maybe.
With a very light wind in the evening, we sail into the night again, and we have a beautiful sunset just behind Tenerife. And we could see the tide, a big volcano on Tenerife, just next to the sun. We decided to take an anchorage for the night and not moor, because it's easier to just drop your anchor when you come in tired. I think we arrived around 1 o'clock. And so we took some hours sleep, and then the next morning we moored in the Marina of Santa Cruz.